law says you must maintain the minimum amount of liability insurance to operate your vehicle on the roadway.
Aw, this is the best gift ever, Uncle Dale!
Owners and operators of motor vehicles are financially responsible for damages or injuries that they cause to others. If not, be able to prove that you can self-insure yourself.
Whoa! Whoa! This is crazy, Uncle Dale!
Behind you.
Here you are. The eagle flies in the pale moonlight,
which allows the big mouth bass to sing.
What? What does that mean?
I don't know. I don't write this stuff. I just repeat it.
Okay, so that's your disguise?
Yeah, I know. It's not very impressive, huh? You know, it wasn't always like this. In the old days.
Yeah.
You know, one time, I was a gazelle.
Okay. Well, if you wouldn't mind kind of speeding it up here, I don't have all day.
Hang on, you're in good hands. I need to tell you what you're gonna get.
Okay, but like I said, I don't have a lot of time, so you can kind of pick up the pace here.
Look, I'm like a good neighbor. You know what this is?
The minimum.
Yeah, but it's just the minimum.
For now, maybe I'll get more later.
Sure, that's what they all say. Here's your little piece of the rock.
This is it?
You ask for the minimum, that's the minimum.
Doesn't seem like much.
That's everything. It's $30,000 of coverage for each injured person, up to a total of $60,000 per collision, and $25,000 for property damage per collision.
But what if I have four or five people in the car and they all get hurt?
Ah, well, if you're worried about not having enough insurance in case of a collision, then you need more insurance than the minimum required amount, and then your liability is covered.
So I'm good now.
Yeah, and good luck on your mission. Hey, you know, on one mission, I was a gazelle.
Okay. But what if I get caught without it?
Oh, you don't want to try that. The state has severe penalties for violating the state's financial responsibility law. The first conviction will result in a fine between $175 and $350.
Whoa! That's a lot of money, is that all?
Oh, no, it gets worse. If you don't keep up your insurance, subsequent convictions can result in fines of $350 to $1,000. Suspension of your driver's license and impoundment of your vehicle.
But what if there are more incidents?
Nah, then they slap you with a tuna fish for 18 straight hours and poke you with rusty forks for 3 days.
Really? Sounds like an election coup.
Now, do you really want to find that out?
Okay, I get it. I'll keep it on me.
Smart man.
That was easy. So easy anyone could do it. I appreciate it.
Hang on. One more thing before you go. You're gonna need this.
What? Why? You said I was covered. You said I had everything I needed. Here. Recycle the paper, save the trees.
No, you're still gonna have to have that on you at all times. You gotta show proof of insurance to get your registration and your inspection sticker.
What does this have to be so hard? Why do I have to keep this with me at all time? What if I lose it?
Well,
isn't there anything else I could do?
You could keep it in your glove box of the car. Now, if that's too much for you, you could always get the proof of self-insured motorist coverage.
What's that?
Well, that means that you showed that you can meet the state minimums out of your own pocket, which means you have to carry around $100,000 in cash at all times.
No one's gonna do that. It's hard enough to do this.
You think that's hard? Tomorrow I gotta go to El Paso and spend the day as a speed bump waiting on my next contact.
Whoa, glad I'm just a contact.
Well, last month in Houston, I had to spend 3 days dressed as a stop sign waiting on a contact.
Whoa, that's a pretty bad assignment.
Well, the good thing is that nobody spotted me. The bad thing is, nobody stopped. Hey, you know, one time,
I was a gazelle. Yeah, you know, this gazelle thing's starting to kind of creep me out a little bit.
Thank you.